Good afternoon and welcome back to the National Basketball Arena. We're about to get underway here in the Under-19A Boys League Final. It's between Presentation Brothers Cork and Colossal Column from Ballincollig Cork. I'm joined for this one by Irish Under 20 Men's Assistant Coach Jimmy Ward. And Jimmy, as we see the fast basket here, a good game in prospect.
Yeah, absolutely. It should be a very exciting game. A lot of these players playing together on the Neptune National League Cup winning team here, as well as Ballincollig are back here after a cup final loss earlier in the year against St Aidan CBS, so should be an exciting game, Matt.
So the first basket is on the board from Dara O'Sullivan. And Ballincollig off to the fast start with four quick points. Jenkins, MVP winner in the National Cup Finals with Neptune, and first basket of the game for Presentation Brothers Cork. And do we have a favourite here, or is it close to call?
I think it's a bit too close to call, to be honest, Matt. Like, I know Ballincollig probably have a lot of names you'd recognise a bit easier, but any team that has Sean Jenkins and David Murray on it, you can't really rule them out.
And another big three from Darrow Sullivan. He's had a fast start to the game. Here's Murray, another Irish international. Missed shot, well rebounded by Anaba inside. The two players slide across the end line. Good hustle from O'Connor, and it will be Pres ball. Jenkins again looks to drive the baseline. Well defended by Sullivan, but Jenkins goes up and over the top, gets his first basket of the game, and we're 7-4. Corkery to Sullivan in the corner. Sullivan, tough baseline jump shot, good defense. Getting a hand up on the ball from O'Connor. And a nice pass from Murray, but Murray can't finish. And Corkery starts the fast break. And Lynch, it will be O'Sullivan, who's had the ball in his hands a lot, and finds his third basket of the game for Ballincollig.
Yeah, and a very quick transition, defense to offense there by both teams up and down the floor here so far.
And Jenkins, the basket, with a fist pump as he gets an and one score, so he'll go to the foul line to try and cut the lead. And Jimmy, no sign of nerves for either team in the first 2 minutes of this one?
No, absolutely not. Both teams going at it, going at each other there. I suppose there'll be a certain bit of familiarity with each other on the court, be it on the same team or against each other, but both teams are flat out trying to play basketball right now.
So a great start to the game from both teams. As Conor O'Sullivan looks to go to the basket, blocked by Murray. And it's Fitzgerald. Nice outlet pass inside, a good finish on the break to Davey Scott. We're tied at nine. O'Sullivan comes off the screen set from Corkery. Nice inside pass, Corkery, good footwork, fadeaway jump shot is good from Corkery. And the scores just keep on coming.
Yeah, and Dylan Corkery is the sort of player, he's a lot of offensive moves there. He always looks so casual with the ball, but he's very capable on the floor.
And a double team this time from Colossal Column, but a missed shot from Murray is put back in from Davey Scott, who gets his second basket, and we're tied at 11 again. Conor O'Sullivan looks for some space. Benchy back into the hands of Corkery. Corkery is called for a travel.
Yeah, a bit of a tough call. Looked like a jab step from here, but the referee's thought otherwise.
So we're tied at 11, bit of full court pressure. Dara O'Sullivan, it's Jenkins, and a good trap results in a steal and into the hands of Conor O'Sullivan, who gets the basket, and a great piece of defensive work for Colossal Column results in an easy two.
Yeah, and great body control there from O'Sullivan there as he made his way to the basket with Jenkins coming across him. Picked away by Anaba there, still in the hands of Prez.
Jenkins being tightly guarded by Colossal Column. They'll know what he's capable of. But at the moment, it's Davey Scott who is picking them apart. We're tied at 13. Nice cut from Corkery. Can't finish, though. It's a good pass from Michael Lynch. And Jenkins wastes no time in finding Murray. And Murray with a nice touch of the glass, but can't finish. Gets his own rebound. But eventually bobbles into the hands of Dylan Corkery. And it would be Colossal Column to Dara O'Sullivan. Tough shot from Sullivan, rebounded by Murray, and Jenkins has a bit of space. Nice pass to Fitzgerald. Doesn't finish, but Jenkins puts back in. And the first lead of the game for Presentation Brothers Cork. And Jimmy, no time to breathe in this game, really. The score's coming thick
and
fast.
God, yeah, it's hard to keep track of what's even happening out there when you're watching up here. You kind of get sucked into it. It's good basketball on both ends of the floor.
Good rebound from O'Connor, finds Jenkins, and Jenkins is fouled on the fast break by Anivi. And Jimmy, what do we see? What kind of defense have we seen on Sean Jenkins here? A few different looks.
Yeah, like defensively, Jenkins is a tough matchup, because if you overguard him, he'll go past you, and if you step off him, he'll shoot over you. So he's a tough one to match up with there. They're kind of switching different players on him so far here, and he is still getting to the basket. So down the stretch, it'll be interesting to see if they stick with it.
Yeah, two very experienced international coaches in Sean Murphy and Francis O'Sullivan. Both will have game plans for the best players in the team, and sure the players will know exactly what they're doing. And here comes Michael Lynch for Closter Column, trying to get them back to parity. Nice drive from Lynch as he goes up and under. Great finish with a reverse layup from Lynch. Again, a bit of full court pressure from Closter Column, and it's Fitzgerald for three. And our first 3-pointer of the game, or actually our second first for Presentation Brothers.
It's so good to see, Matt. You have a game right now where you have five basketball players on each team that are well able to shoot, score, dribble.
And there we see another one as Conor O'Sullivan puts in the basket, and we'll take a timeout here as it's 18-17 to Presentation Brothers. So welcome back here. It's a 1-point game. Presentation Brothers leading Closter Column by a point as Jenkins wastes no time in getting back into things. Fitzgerald for three. That's back-to-back threes of Fitzgerald.
Yeah, Fitzgerald's on fire here. 100% shooting from three.
Conor O'Sullivan finds a bit of space, pulls up for a jumper. That bounced out, but good tip from Corky. Manages to keep it into the hands of Lynch, and Lynch finds Conor O'Sullivan. And a nice move from Dao O'Sullivan, but he can't finish. And Jenkins finds that hot man, Fitzgerald. A nice pass inside to Murray, and good ball movement from Prez. And a foul's call, I think, on Murray. It is. So 21-17. 2 minutes, just over 2 minutes to go in this first quarter.
Yeah, neat pass from Murray there. Probably in that position, might have been best suited to take himself to the basket, but he's sharing the ball quite well.
So O'Sullivan inside. Dao O'Sullivan. Conor O'Sullivan fakes the three. Finds a bit of space. Corkery will take a three. And Corkery hits a three. Waste no time here as Fitzgerald to Jenkins. Jenkins being closely guarded by Michael Lynch. He's been given that job. Nice pass on the baseline. But good defense. Shuts down O'Connor before he gets a chance to shoot it. And a good block from Anivi. Dao O'Sullivan, tough shot and well blocked from William O'Connor. And Jenkins again on the fast break, and a reaching foul is called on Michael Lynch. Probably a good tactic to slow things down.
Yeah, absolutely. Let his teammates get back in defense. I'd be happy to sacrifice a foul there. Interesting to see though on defense that Prez was sitting in his zone there, Matt. Like a Ballincollig, not the sort of team I'd like to invite to shoot on me.
Fitzgerald on the wing. Finds Jenkins inside, and Jenkins, a nice finish of a great assist from Fitzgerald. Corkery to O'Sullivan. Zone defense just slowing them down, but Corkery made his last three, gets another one. Good hand from Anabi.
Yeah, good work from Anabi there, chasing down that loose rebound there. Did enough to get a deflection off the presentation court player.
O'Sullivan takes a deep three. He makes it look very simple.
Yeah, very confident looking shooter on the ball as well there.
And both teams putting on an offensive display here at the moment. Fitzgerald, who's made his own share of threes into the hands of Davey Scott. He's got a couple of baskets himself. Murray, nice spin move from Murray. And another great inside move from David Murray.
And Murray literally covered acres with that drop step going to the basket. From the top of the key with one dribble. Fantastic stuff to watch.
Dar O'Sullivan. Long two from O'Sullivan. With 18 seconds to go in this first quarter that has flown by. It's 25 apiece. Murray finds O'Connor. And it's into the hands of Jenkins, as you expect, with 6 seconds to go on the clock. He'll be looking for the last shot here. Jenkins finds a bit of space. Fade away. Jump shot. And Jenkins hits that. So the buzzer goes. At the end of a pulsating first quarter, it's Presentation Brothers Cork 27, Colossal Column 25. So here we go, the Presentation Brothers will start this second quarter. And Jimmy, just give us a couple of things. What have you noticed from each team that might help them win this game?
Yeah, like the transition from defense to offense by both teams is fantastic there. I do think their presentation will look for the likes of Jenkins and Murray a lot, but if Fitzgerald here continues to shoot as he does on cue there, dropping another long two. While Ballincollig have so many offensive weapons there, it'd be a case of if they utilize them with each other well. Nice pass inside to Anaba from Corkery, doesn't get it. Rebound by Corkery inside. Up and deemed to have been fouled there. He can go to the line to shoot too. And perhaps Presentation can't afford to give away a second chance opportunities, Matt, to Ballincollig here in instances like this.
So a great first quarter from both teams here. Don't forget, still to come is the under 16A final between two of the powerhouses of schools basketball, the Bish from Galway and St. Malachy's from Belfast. Murray finds a bit of space at the top of the key and not giving Jenkins too much space. Baseline jumper from O'Connor doesn't go. And it'll be Conor Sullivan finds a bit of space to Corkery. Corkery back to O'Sullivan. Decides not to pass to the inside man and nails a three.
Why go for two when you have three, Matt?
So pace remains relentless. If they can keep this up, we're going to have a fantastic game of basketball as we have so far, and good rebound. And it's Conor O'Sullivan look to push for Closh the Column. Corkery makes the extra pass back to Dar O'Sullivan, who gets into the lane with a floater. And Dar O'Sullivan with a beautiful move down the middle of the lane.
Interesting to see in the last couple of possessions, Matt, that Ballincolly doing a great job of keeping Murray out of the post, receiving the ball there, forcing him to come high to get it.
Emmanuel Anaba doing a good job on his side of the zone with Murray. As into the game for the first time will come Andrew O'Connor, replacing Davy Scott. So Jenkins, guarded by Corkby. Jenkins is fouled on the three. Corkby's claiming good defense. He was up there early, but I think a little bit of contact on the body. Sometimes you see him call, sometimes you don't.
Yeah, and at the risk of putting a hex on Jenkins there, he's pretty automatic from traditional line. He has been most of the year. What I see in National League games and school games, but I guess commentators, of course, there.
Secret Closh the Column fan, Jimmy, are you?
I'm a basketball fan, Matt.
Normality resumes as Jenkins knocks down the second. And once the hex was removed, makes no problem knocking down the two. And into the game, for the first time, comes Owen O'Reilly for Closh the Column. And the Michael Lynch takes a break.
Probably the biggest lineup we've seen for Ballincollig here, height-wise, on the floor, as they maybe look to work inside on Prez, maybe.
Well, Sullivan misses, but rebound by Anabi, and Corkby finds the new man. Sullivan maybe got away with a little bit of travel, but gets the ball to Dow Sullivan, who knocks down another three. And it's 35-31. And steal from Colo Sullivan. He's a bit of space. Jenkins back on defense. And a foul by Jenkins. Good move from O'Sullivan. As he picks off the pass and gets the foul line.
Great use by O'Sullivan's body there. Drew the contact. Probably knew Jenkins was a bit too rangy and would have blocked him if he went straight up with it. So we'll be happy to settle for the free throws.
Sullivan makes one of two. Jenkins uses the high screen. Fitzgerald, nice pass inside, but good swarming defense, and Ballincollig ends up with a block from O'Reilly, I think. Probably take credit for it, and it is O'Reilly who'll take a long two and somehow banks it in.
Great shot by O'Reilly there.
Jenkins looking for space to baseline. And where there was none, he found some but couldn't finish. And it's Colo Sullivan leading the break. And he finds Dow Sullivan, takes a long two. Foot in the line, but knocks it down. A timeout called from Presentation Brothers. As Closh the Column take a lead with 5 minutes to go. We're back shortly. So a 9-point lead for Closh the Column over Presentation Brothers Court, and Jenkins can't find good defense from Closh the Column. They get a couple of hands on it, and in the end, Andrew O'Connor can't keep it in.
Yeah, it was a clever cut by O'Connor there, but perhaps wasn't expecting the ball to get to him as early.
So Conor O'Sullivan, high screen from Corkery, finds a bit of space, floater from O'Sullivan, rebound by Corkery, who used his body well against David Murphy, sticks in the two.
Yeah, presentation coming out of that timeout now in man defence, hoping to change it up a little bit, slow down the shooting from Ballincollig.
Murray, good call there inside, he's been grabbed. And Jimmy, big lead, well, a large lead considering it's been relatively tight for the whole game, 11-point lead. What will Presby be looking to try and do to stem the flow and get back into the game as Jenkins takes a two from the corner?
Yeah, they'll be definitely looking to get Murray on the blocks a bit more. Like the couple of times he did earlier on the game, he got to the basket, got fouled, got baskets, but at the minute, Ballincollig doing a good job of shepherding him. As Corkery goes to the basket there, gets the bucket, will shoot the bonus free throw.
Great drive from O'Sullivan, and has the court awareness to find the cutting Corkery, and he's fouled, so it's now a 13-point lead. In danger time a little bit for Shawnee Murphy and Press Brothers as he knocks down the free throw. So Jenkins will be looking for a score. Fitzgerald was the man earlier on, and he finds on the baseline. Nice shot from William O'Connor. Tough shot from the short corner, but makes it look easy. Dow O'Sullivan can't find him, and O'Connor with a steal. Jenkins has people in front of him, finds Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald, nice pass inside to Murphy. And all of a sudden, quick 4 points with a chance to make it five. The lead is cut in half.
Yeah, and that's an easy. You need to get the ball to Murray early there where he gets good position like that, because he's a legitimate threat down below, as Francis Sullivan calls a timeout to talk about it. 33-45 in favour of Ballincollig.
So David Murphy at the line for Presentation Brothers Cork, with a chance to cut this lead.
Murray rocking the powder blue Nike shoes there.
And Abby gets it to Conor O'Sullivan, again uses the high screen from Corkery and finds a bit of space. Nice pass to cutting Anaba, but he can't finish, but does a good job of keeping hold of the ball. And a foul has gone on Jenkins. Yeah. And that will be Sean's second.
Good work from Anab inside there. He's not really one of their main offensive go-to guys. He's primarily a defender and rebounder there, but that time did well.
Sullivan, this time screen from Dillon. A nice drive from O'Sullivan, but can't finish. And Jenkins has the ball. So it's 3-on-3. Jenkins gets past it. Early contact, but a lot of contact there, but a good stand. Judge O'Reilly, probably a good call. And O'Sullivan, he can't finish, and a foul is called this end.
Yeah, late call there. We had two trips up the floor very fast. Matt Jenkins literally covered 80 feet of floor with maybe four dribbles there.
And that's the third foul on William O'Connor. And there we see a little bit of one, you know, without wanting to criticise the referees, one was a no call, probably a good call, and the other one was a foul, and probably both should have been the same call, whichever way they were.
Absolutely, yeah, you see that from time to time, and we have to also remember the referees are out there, everyone makes mistakes.
Fitzgerald from the corner made his last two. Nice fake from Jenkins, finds a bit of space.
No contact call again. And as a player, Matt, yourself, you'd be like me, you don't mind if a referee makes good or bad calls, provided they're consistently good on each team.
That's it. It's difficult when it goes up and down, because you one referee's making a call one end and one's making it the other. But the same referee, you would hope, will make the same call both ends, which is often the case. And in fairness, the refereeing has been very good. But in a game like this, it's getting very physical in there. And
possession jump ball in favour of Kalasha Cullen Ballincollig there.
So,
and with 2 minutes left in the second quarter, even though there is maybe a 10-11 point lead here, you'd feel that it's not much. It's just no more than a 3-basket lead from either team here.
O'Reilly makes a baseline jump shot and extends the lead here.
Good hands by O'Reilly on the defensive end again as Dara Sullivan sets off. Waits for options here. Colin pulls up from range, drops it through.
Conor O'Sullivan is at the hot hand for the whole game here, and it's presentation brothers score that's just died off here after a superb first quarter. Only 10 so far in this second quarter. And a missed shot from Murray is rebounded by O'Reilly, who just about manages to get it in the hands of Conor O'Sullivan, who finds Dar O'Sullivan for three. That one bobbles out, but Anabi does a great job again. Back out to Conor O'Sullivan. And Corkery can't keep that one in bounds. So just 1:30 to go in this first half. It's Kalasha Cullen that lead presentation brothers 51-35.
And Kalasha Cullen still doing a good job of keeping Murray out of the paint there. Forced to receive the ball above the key on a couple of occasions.
Missed shot by Andrew O'Connor. And it will be press ball. As into the game comes Jack Lynch. First appearance of Jack today. And Sean Jenkins inside to Murray. It's Fitzgerald. They need Fitzgerald to start making another three. Fitzgerald is doing what he's supposed to be doing and knocking down the open threes.
He must have heard you there, Matt. Knew the pressure was on.
Just under a minute to go, 13-point lead, so nothing too insurmountable. As here comes Corkery, finds a bit of space, and the foul is called, and the basket count is good. The foul goes on Andrew O'Connor, and good handle and footwork from Corkery.
Yeah, Dylan Corkery, also a member of the under-20 Irish team panel at the minute. Showed a nice little behind the back there, change of direction, and took it to the basket, took the bump, and shoots the bonus.
Corkery misses, but again, Anabi shows his worth as he's cleaned up rebounds and will give Kalasha Cullen another chance here as Conor O'Sullivan looks that little bit of space off the screen and roll. He finds that space, can't finish, but rebound Corkery, and Corkery for two.
I thought Conor O'Sullivan would have thought about a shot there, about 4 foot beyond the three-point line.
Fitzgerald for three, in and out, rebound Anabi, and good outlet from Anabi, 20 seconds to go. O'Sullivan encouraged by his bench to slow it up and wait for one more shot. And why not? They've had a great first half. And Corkery, pass Murray, and Corkery. Beautiful finish off the backboard. And the clock shot, clock ticks down. Jenkins tries to get one more score. And a massive call there as Jenkins is called for a charge, which will be his third.
Yeah, that's a big call right there, so it is. Generally in situations like that, the offensive player gets the benefit of the doubt going to the basket, Matt, but on that occasion, yes, I thought otherwise.
So 4.2 seconds to go. Kalasha Cullen has called for a sub, so it'll stay 4.2 seconds to go. And a 19-point lead, Jimmy, come out of nowhere a little bit.
Yeah, it did actually. Literally, it crept to a 10-point lead, and from there, they really built on it quite fast through the shooting of Corkery and through O'Sullivan there. But like, to be honest, it's still not a game that's gone beyond presentation here, I feel.
O'Reilly will take the shot on the buzzer. And you shouldn't be surprised, they barely missed a shot all half. And after a fantastic offensive display in the first half by Kalasha Cullen, they lead Presentation Brothers 59-38. So welcome back, National Basketball Arena. It's the Under-19A League Final. Cluster Column leading Presentation Brothers Court 59-38. And Jimmy, great first quarter from both teams scoring-wise, but the scoring dropped off in that second quarter from Presentation. What will they be looking to do to try and close this 19-point gap, or 21-point gap, sorry?
Yeah, I think they won't need to panic initially, Matt. Just keep chipping away there. In fairness, Clashcull and Ballincollig, they have shot the ball at an incredibly high percentage there. Perhaps they might not be able to maintain that, but keep defensively, keep in track of the shooters, and offensively keep going to the basket there. Try to look for Murray inside and O'Connor as Jenkins gets fouled there. He'll shoot the two free throws.
And Jenkins been on three fouls. Is that going to play a big part in this game, or will he be able to cope with that?
Yeah, I think Jenkins is a clever enough player and experienced enough to realise that. He'll be watchful of the fouls there. Having said that, though, Kalasha Collum will also know he's on three and will look to take the ball at him.
So Jenkins gets the first basket of the second half. And a great job in the first half from Kalasha Collum defending him, but as we've seen in plenty of big games this year, he's tough to keep out of the game for 40 minutes. You'd expect a reaction in the second half. As
yeah, and Prez pushing much further out on that zone defense there, trying to limit the shots from Kalash to Collum there as Jenkins gets the rebound.
Well, Sullivan missed that first one, but good steal from Corkley. Jenkins will have to be careful there, and does make a good stand from Jenkins. Out the court, Darryl Sullivan just missed his last one, but pulled out of sight up.
Great shot from O'Sullivan there, as they say. Shooters make shots because they're not afraid to miss.
So noticeable change in that Davey Scott is running the point here for Press Brothers. Give a little bit more space to Jenkins maybe. We've got an injury down there as Manuel Anaba has taken a knock.
Can't see from this position where he took the knock. Looks like he's holding his nose, perhaps. Maybe he got a slight bang in the face.
Yeah, looks like he's been banging the nose, so he'll come off. We'll take a look as Michael Lynch checks back in.
And Anaba is a vital player here. Offensively, he doesn't contribute much, but defensively, he's an exceptional defender. And they're doing a great job with Murray so far.
Fitzgerald finds a bit of space off to Sullivan. Good ball movement and shot from Scott doesn't go. Rebounded by Darryl Sullivan, gets it to Connor O'Sullivan. And he finds a new man, Lynch. As Ballincollig slows things down a little bit. Nice cut from Lynch and good spin move, but Jenkins gets his hands on the ball. Scott with a floater. Doesn't go in, but good rebound from Murray. Jenkins gets the ball on the baseline. Nice pass inside to Murray, and Murray this time finishes. Great pass from Jenkins to Murray.
Yeah, they didn't keep chipping away at this lead here, Matt. As I said, try and limit the outside threat from Ballincollig as Conor O'Sullivan on cue pulls up and drop shot rebound by Corkery.
And O'Reilly has proved himself to be an excellent shooter from that range, as he's made a couple from that short range. Go to Fitzgerald, tough shot, doesn't go. Rebound O'Reilly and starts to break into the hands of Conor O'Sullivan behind the back. Slides on the floor and a travel is called. As into the game comes Killian McNamara for the first time as he gives Fitzgerald a rest. I think that might have been Shawnee Murphy telling him he didn't approve of the last running jump shot on the baseline.
Yeah, perhaps. And especially against a team like Kalasha Collum, who rebound quite well, shot selection is very important.
Jenkins finds a gap down the middle, and Jenkins gets the basket for two. And Jimmy, clear change in tactics from Shawnee Murphy here, putting Sean Jenkins at the top.
Absolutely,
of the
yeah.
zone. What's he trying to look to do? What are we trying to get Sean open for in there?
Well, to be honest, Sean gets the ball on top of the zone there. He's the sort of player, he can take on two or three players there. He's good in traffic, he can pass out of it there if he doesn't get all the way to basket. And they'll really need him down this 5 minute stretch in the third to keep them within touching distance of Kalasha Collum.
So 90 point lead, O'Reilly. Back to Wiley in the corner. Conor O'Sullivan finds Cork at the top of the key, and Vidal O'Sullivan for a long three. O'Sullivan wags his finger at the crowd as he knocks down his second three of the second half. And steal eventually into the hands of Corkery and then Dow O'Sullivan. And all the breaks seem to go for Kolostek Kolem as the ball's deflected, but ends up back in the hands of Dow O'Sullivan. He knocks down another long two.
Yeah, and right now Dow O'Sullivan could throw the ball from the motorway and he'd find the basket. Right now he's really the hot hand for Kolostek Kolem.
Yeah, a fantastic shooting performance from Ballincollig as a team, but particularly both O'Sullivans. This time it's Davy Scott, can't make it, and it's Conor O'Sullivan who finds Lynch, and Lynch can't finish. It's rebounded by the new man McNamara, and Jenkins gets a bit of space going to the basket. Superb finish from Jenkins.
Excellent pass by Jenkins there, full reach. As Conor O'Sullivan, the other end, takes it strong, doesn't get it to go. Rebound by McNamara. Murray on the ball here, crosses half court, has options ahead, sees it.
Jenkins kicks back out, it'll be a long two. Doesn't go, but good rebound, Jenkins, and Jenkins with a floater, and Jenkins, a couple of nice baskets in a row, and the speed is picked up here, as it's a 20-point lead still. Conor O'Sullivan fakes the three. Takes the foul line jumper, doesn't go, and good box out by Jenkins.
Yeah, Jenkins is really keeping their presentation the flow here offensively. With 3:44 left in the third, if they can chip maybe another 6-7 points off this, it'll make an interesting game going into the fourth.
Here is Jenkins at the top of the key. Backs out with nowhere to go, looking for cutters, and eventually they find Murray inside. Murray, bit of space, and Murray gets the basket, can't finish, and they need those to go. It's Conor O'Sullivan. Slows things down a little bit for Kolostek Kolem. O'Reilly from long range, doesn't go, rebound Murray. And Jenkins sees two defenders in front of him, makes a good pass. Great steal from Corkery, and then he splits the defenders and finds Conor O'Sullivan up in front, and O'Sullivan for two, and a fantastic bit of defense from Corkery. Jenkins for three off the high screen, doesn't go, rebound Corkery, and it's still Kolostek Kolem that continue to dominate this game. Conor O'Sullivan finds a bit of space, nice pass inside to Corkery, and Corkery with a beautiful wraparound finish inside.
Yeah, and Corkery linking up very well with all of his teammates there on both ends of the floor. But Jenkins is garnering a double team on offense here for presentation.
Jenkins gets around the double team, nice floater from Jenkins. Good ball movement again. Oh, fantastic pass of a cut from between Corkery and Lynch, and a great finish from Michael Lynch. And Jimmy, Kolostek Kolem just continued to keep playing team basketball, moving the ball. There's another fantastic basket from Jenkins.
Yeah, absolutely.
Jenkins.
And like, while Prez are getting baskets through Jenkins, you just get the impression that Kolostek Kolem are getting easier baskets and not having to work as hard for them.
The ball movement from Kolostek Kolem has been excellent throughout. Barely dribbled the ball here as Dow O'Sullivan finds Conor O'Sullivan, gets a bit of penetration, short jump shot, doesn't go, but grabs his own rebounds. The shot clock will reset to 14 as Dow O'Sullivan finds an open Dylan Corkery, and Corkery knocks down a three. And an exhibition being put on here by Kolostek Kolem.
Good pass out of the Dublin, picked off by O'Sullivan though, has space ahead and a help player as he goes all the way to basket for an easy layup.
And when a team plays this well, I mean, really not much you can do about it. Presentation aren't playing badly.
No, not at all. It's just that Kalash and Colm are playing exceptionally well, shooting the ball very well, and the ball movement is absolutely a joy to watch here, Matt.
As Coach Shawnee Murphy makes the changes, presentation on 53 points on 8 minute quarters is a more than respectable score, but a huge 80 points being put up from Kalash to Colm. It was a nice fadeaway jump shot from Murray. Cuts the lead a little bit, but with 34 seconds to go, it'll be Kalash to Colm with a chance to extend their lead. As into the game for the first time comes Isaac James and a long three from Corby. Good defense this time from Fitzgerald.
Someone must have left the window open there, and the wind blew a bit of power out of that shot there as Jenkins comes down across to half court. Rebound by Darrell Sullivan.
So 12 seconds to go. Darrell Sullivan just slows things down. The call is made by Coach Francis Sullivan to what play he wants. It's a high screen from Corkley. We saw a lot of that in the first half, but a slip from O'Sullivan into the hands of Corkley, who misses the three. So at the end of the third quarter, it's Kalash to Colm 80, Presentation Brothers 55. So here we go, final quarter of the 19A Boys Schools League Final. And Jimmy, Presentation Brothers put up a good fight in that third quarter, but the scoring of Kalash to Colm is just a little bit too much at the moment.
Yeah, just relentless. That third quarter, they still kept a high shooting percentage up while making Perez work very hard in defense with excellent ball movement. But hey, 25 points in 7 minutes is not, well, 27 points is not out the gate too much.
Another nice shot from O'Reilly. He's done a good job since he came into the game in that second quarter. He's got 8 points so far. Inside Murray, sorry, blocked by Corkley. But good hustle from Murray. Fights it, gets the ball down, and the foul has gone on Michael Lynch.
Yeah, and perhaps Perez having Fitzgerald back in the game, they might look to him to take some of the scoring pressure off Jenkins, who at the minute is trying to carry the team.
Yeah, Fitzgerald with some big threes so far in the game, and they need a few more of those here. The ball goes to Jenkins in the corner, closely guarded by Corkery, and here is Fitzgerald. This time he puts the ball on the floor and finds Murray. Can't make that jump shot, but tipped from Jenkins, but ends up in the hands of Conor O'Sullivan for Kalash to Colm. And here is O'Reilly.
That's
kicked
great.
Out Corkery. And the onslaught continues from the three-point line.
And it's great to see at school level, Matt, a player like O'Reilly there who knows the role on the team. That time they're outside the tree, had an open shot, but chose to pass it to a teammate who would be perhaps more of a threat from out there.
Yeah, himself. And Emmanuel Anaba have done a great job of linking things together amongst the high scoring of Corkery and the two O'Sullivans.
Isaac James with the WrestleMania jump ball there.
Yeah, Kieran Fitzgerald pulled fully off the floor. And into the game comes Hugh Murphy for the first time for Closter Colum. And Tom Benneman checks back in to the game for Prez. It's a 30-point lead here. Jenkins with a steal. Gets it forward to O'Connor. O'Connor can't finish, but rebound Jenkins, and Jenkins is fouled from behind from O'Reilly. And he'll go to the line for two shots. And that is five fouls.
On O'Reilly, is it?
O'Reilly.
Sitting now, he will be a loss considering he's after producing some very productive basketball in the absence of Anava, who left the game earlier with an injury.
Yeah, good performance from O'Reilly. They chipped in with 8 points and some nice passes inside. Don't forget, still to come, the under-16A final as Jenkins makes the free throw. St. Malachy's from Belfast versus St. Joe's the Bish from Galway.
Jenkins knocking the door of 30 points here. He's very impressive offensive performance. You wouldn't expect that unless from a man rocking all-white Jordan 11s.
So here we have a bit of full-court pressure. Connor O'Sullivan makes light work of Andrew O'Connor and adds another two to his score.
Jenkins turns the corner. Excellent feed to Murray going to the basket.
Another great assist. Jenkins close to 30, as you said, but also with a lot of nice passes involved as well.
Yeah, he really is a fantastic player to watch play basketball, as O'Connor takes it all the way, rims out, but he'll go to the line for two. Perhaps a defensive switch might be in order for Perez, as O'Connor seems to be struggling, hanging on to Connor O'Sullivan there.
Yeah, the last two plays since they switched the man-to-man, one-on-one for O'Sullivan as he gets to earn these from the line. So 5:40 to go in this final quarter. It's still a 30-point lead. Jenkins just tries to save a few seconds on the clock, and he finds Fitzgerald inside to Murray. Nice pass, Murray. Nice extra pass, but Tom Brenneman wasn't quite ready for it. It'll bounce out of bounds, so it'll be Ballincollig's ball.
Yeah, and that was the right option there. Just unfortunately, Brenneman wasn't ready for the pass. Great move by Murray inside.
So Conor O'Sullivan slows things down with double screen at the top. Dow O'Sullivan. Foul line jump shot doesn't go. Rebound Jenkins. And he gets it forward quickly to Fitzgerald. Here's Brenneman. Finds Murray. Murray on the baseline, but good defense of Anabi. He knocks out of bounds.
Yeah, great forward by Anabi, closing off that baseline drive from Murray. As Corkery knocks it out of bounds.
Jenkins in the corner. Sent to the baseline by Corkery. Bounced in and out, rebound by Sullivan, and he finds Connor, tries to find Connor Sullivan, but good defense from a mixture of Murray and O'Connor. And Fitzgerald is called for a double dribble. So 4:45 to go. Dow Sullivan with the ball for Closter Colum, finds Connor Sullivan inside, who will take a long two, doesn't go. Eventually rebounded by Brenneman, and here comes Jenkins. Finds a little bit of space, but good hands from Corkery, and Connor Sullivan is off to the races. And Connor Sullivan finishes the fast break as we have a timeout called, with Closter Colum leading 91-59. So welcome back. Klosh Connell will ring the chains a little bit. Hugh Murphy checking into the game for the first time. He's joined by Alan O'Leary.
And even though there's 4:15 left in the fourth, Matt, and there's no such thing as a perfect game of basketball, Ballincollig producing some excellent basketball here in this game.
Yeah, we wondered after the first quarter if both teams would be able to keep it up, but it was, I think, 28-27 is a nice move from Murray. And Klosh Connell certainly have been able to keep it up for the whole game. Sale 91.
Connell on the floor.
Rebound Jenkins. He has Brenneman in front of him, and Brenneman makes the two. Yeah. 63-91. Dylan Corkery. Banks one off the glass. Oh, when you can bank one from straight on, you know it's your day.
Absolutely, especially here in the arena. Jenkins takes the basket for two.
Another great touch from Jenkins. He adds to his total. Corkery looks a bit of space. Gets it to Connor O'Sullivan. Connor O'Sullivan for three. Doesn't go. Rebound Jenkins. Gets it forward to Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald will pull up for three. Can't make that. With 2:43 to go. And Abby, nice inside pass, but well blocked by O'Connor.
Darryl Sullivan checks back in the game here.
Connor Sullivan. Corkery, missed shot, rebound Jenkins. And he finds Fitzgerald in the corner. Took a flex off the foot.
Perhaps took a few baby steps to gather that ball there, but when you're trailing like this, most refs would let some of that slide.
And David McMahon checks into the game for his first appearance. And it's Emmanuel Inaba takes a break. Again, excellent work from Inaba. He's done the little things that have allowed the scorers to score. And there Fitzgerald comes off and makes another three. Darryl O'Sullivan finds Connor O'Sullivan. Fakes the three into the corner for Corkery. Jenkins pushes the ball for Presentation Brothers. He won't stop playing, you can be sure of that. And checking in comes Killian McNamara as O'Connor takes a break.
Presentation with 68 points on the board, Matt. And any other day, that'd be probably a winning score in a schools game with 8 minute quarters, but just not today as Klosh Connell again pick off the steal here and run in the easy two.
Yeah, you're exactly right. You can't say that players haven't played well. Just in Klosh Connell, they've come up against a team that have simply been exceptional offensively and not too shabby defensively either in terms of stopping Jenkins. Jenkins has 30, but he's had to work hard for them.
Yeah, they did a good job of letting Jenkins get his points, but containing everybody else, Matt. As Dylan Corkery sits for the first time this game. He had 23 points at the half there, so.
And Jimmy, you're going to be called on to make the MVP here. Must be a couple of people in the reckoning.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Well, on the president's side, you got to say Sean Jenkins is probably offensively the most potent threat out there. Murray also fought quite hard, but on the other side, Klosh Connell, you've at least four players, Matt, you could look at there. Both the O'Sullivans, Corkery, and even O'Reilly was exceptional when he was on the floor. So God help anyone who is that decision trying to choose an MVP out of it.
So 1:20 to go.
Six 68-95 in favour of Kalasha Kolumbalik Kolig, as Isaac James looks set to check back in here after the free throws. First shot is a little short off the iron. As O'Leary is short with the second rebound, Jenkins crossed the halfway point, 1:18 left in the clock. Picked off from behind. Darrell Sullivan, that man who's been such a threat all day, passes ahead to Connor O'Sullivan.
And you see the bench scoring as well, as Jack Lynch checks into the game and he knocks down his first shot. The strength and depth today has been one of the main issues, or one of the main keys for Kalasha Kolumbalik, would you say?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Jenkins pulls up for a long three here, gets it a fall, puts a bit of respectability on the scoreline here.
So a 98-71, a huge score from Kalasha Kolumbalik as the clock goes below 50 seconds. The foul is called.
Yeah, it was a good idea there. James had cut back door, but unfortunately it wasn't seen. As Connor O'Sullivan makes way here for Lynch checking back in.
Yeah, fantastic game scoring wise from Connor O'Sullivan. And the trio of the two O'Sullivans and Corkery.
And that looks
picked up his fourth.
They'll go to the line to shoot two here. Two free throws here would put that glossy 100 points on the board, Matt. Very impressive for 8 minute quarters here. I won't say anything in case I jinx young Lynch at the line there.
Yeah, he managed to fight through the jinx there to knock that one in. And he does make it. An even 100 for Kalasha Kolumbalik. A fantastic performance against any team, but a team that has Sean Jenkins and David Murray in their lineup makes it even more impressive.
Yeah, and Prez, have to said, still playing right to the end buzzer regardless of the score there.
A nice steal from Isaac James. James gets it forward to Lynch, and Lynch finished on the break. Exactly as you said, there's no thought of them running out the clock here. Jenkins to Fitzgerald for three, doesn't go, rebound Jenkins. Gets his own rebound and he's fouled, I think, by David McMahon.
Yeah, and you gotta love the competitiveness of Jenkins there, Matt. Relentless, even though the cause is gone at this stage.
Jenkins adds to his tally. And with 12.7 seconds to go. Jimmy, just give us a quick rundown. How impressive has Kalasha Kolumbalik been in this game?
Yeah, absolutely. On both ends of the floor, Matt. Impressive on defense and how they contained the other four players. On offense, they were unmatchable. And celebrations here in the arena probably drowned us out a little bit.
Yeah, after the cup final defeat, where Kalasha Kolumbalik very much felt like they didn't perform against St. Aidan's, they certainly did perform today, as a nice embrace between Francis O'Sullivan and Sean Murphy below. Two very experienced coaches, and great to see two international coaches giving their time to coach young players in schools basketball.
And both coaches can be very proud of how their players performed today. Unfortunately, they just couldn't match the firepower that Kalasha Kolumbalik had right there. It's Gerald, the hot hand today from outside for presentation, Cork.
Yeah, Yeah, good start to the game presentation, but couldn't keep the score up. In the end, 75 points in 8 minute quarters is still an excellent result as president of Basketballising Ireland, Teresa Walsh and Tom O'Malley of the school's committee hand out the medals.
Sean Jenkins, who had 37 points of the afternoon of his team 75, which is incredibly impressive.
Yeah, you have to say, hugely impressive performance from Jenkins. At no point did he start forcing shots, he still made good decisions, which is good to see from such a high score as himself, 37 points, but in the end, I think Colossal Column just had too many weapons.
Get a fantastic school game here, Matt, at this level is just indicative of how good underage basketball is in Cork at the minute.
I think they're lucky, they've good coaches in Cork, you know, they've good clubs, and then they don't all go to the same school, so you've got a couple of good strong schools. But I mean, I think from Ballincollig's point of view, they've been producing a lot of good young players for a lot of years.
Darrow Sullivan collected a medal there, one of the more impressive players on the floor today, I felt.
So, Dylan Corkery, top scorer for Ballincollig. Sees the MVP trophy, and Jimmy, as you said, any one of the three players, the two Sullivans and Corkery, both hugely, or all three of them hugely impressive today.
For yeah, absolutely, all players on 20 plus points there. Very difficult decision that could have went to any of them as the captains, a trio of captains by the looks of it, heads up.
So Connor, the under 19 A League winners will be Colossal Column. And as they lift the trophy, we're going to take a short break here and we'll be back with you for a 3:30 tip-off for St. Joe's, the Bish Galway, against St. Malachy's.